What's going on, everyone? Welcome to Texas Hunting Channel. If you're new here, definitely consider subscribing and hitting that like button. So today I'm going to explain and show you how I got my 92 to 2000 half-size radiator to fit in with my turbo setup and have the hood being able to close, because this is actually a very common problem with EFs. There's not really a whole lot of information out there on how to do it without getting a traction bar. So one of the issues you have with these radiators is the lower hose hits a hump down there on the factory traction bar, which causes it to where it doesn't want to slide down properly. So what I had to do was get a different hose, which took me a while. I finally found one at O'Reilly's. Here's the part number for that. You basically go in, tell them the part number, get the hose, and I had to trim the hose up. Now, you could probably get this hose at O'Reilly's, AutoZone, Advance Auto Parts, pretty much any parts store that can pull up part numbers, or online, maybe Rock Auto. But it was a pretty cheap hose. So I went ahead and cut it, put some hose clamps on it, and it did pull it back further, as you can see. Now, it's really solid now. You should probably bracket it. I'm probably going to use a bracket on this bolt hole here and bracket it over, just so it has extra strength, even though it's not an issue. But I had to do this because the full-size radiator, didn't matter if it was aftermarket or factory, was in the way for this turbo setup. So let me show you the clearance I have. So as you can see down there where the turbo is, I still have a gap between it. Typically they touch the coupler, but if you do it this way, it works pretty well. And there's not a whole lot of room down there to begin with. So yeah, as you can see though, that spot down there where the pipe is for the intercooler, that's where the factory radiator goes. But this method works pretty well. It does pull it back farther so that the hood has perfect clearance and it doesn't touch, so it's really good. A lot of people have been asking me how I did that, so I figured I'd make a little video for everyone so they can see exactly how I pulled that off. So yeah, what's coming in the next video will actually be Slam-In Welding in Killeen, Texas, is going to be cutting this flange off, turning this hole basically here, just taking the flange, making it line up with this mark that I made. You can see a little picture here of how off it is when it's up to the car. So the flange is for a B-series. This is a B-series downpipe, which does work fine, other than being able to be bolted up. So this flange will actually be turned a little bit and re-welded, so that way I can bolt it to the exhaust. I prefer my turbos cycled through the exhaust system. That's just how I personally like it. Plus, when you do launch control, you get huge fireballs out the back. It's pretty cool. So that will be coming up in the next video, hopefully. That's the plan, at least. So yeah, if you're new here, definitely consider subscribing, turning that bell icon on to get notified of every upload. And if you guys are already here, make sure your bell's turned on, so that way you can get notified, so you know when the videos drop, because I do post at random. I'm trying to get on a schedule. It's kind of hard with my schedule, but I'm gonna do my best to get as many videos out for you guys as I can and go in depth and explain all of this turbo stuff, and maybe even go over some of the tuning with Michael, so that way you guys can understand a little bit more with me. Now, I do know some of the tuning, but I don't know a lot of it, so it'll be a learning process for us both. So yeah, definitely stay tuned. This video should be coming soon, so I'll see you guys in the next one. As I like to say, God bless, stay safe, stay awesome.